Then we had the Adam Cole MJF segment. And MJF and Cole come out, and Cole talks about how his ankle exploded, broken three places, torn ligaments, going to have to get surgery. We'll do everything in his power to get back as soon as possible. And he says, you know, we're the Ring of Honor Tag Team Champions, and we can't defend, so we got to relinquish. And MJF stops him and says, I did not wrestle twice in one night to relinquish my belt to the righteous. He says, you wouldn't believe this, but, you know, you're hurt because of me. And I know how much these belts mean to you. And so when you get back, these belts will be waiting for you. Because on October 1st, I'm going to slide into Seattle and defend the titles against the righteous in a handicap match. So it's 2-on-1. So Roddy then gets wheeled onto the stage by the Kingdom. And he says, Adam, I need you more than ever right now. It's an emergency. And Cole doesn't know what to do. And MJF says, listen, as much as I think Roddy's a simp, I learned a lesson on that boat. He's your boy, so go do what you got to do. And so the Kingdom's screaming, come on, Cole, hurry up. And Cole says, I've got a broken foot. So he hobbles up the ramp and they leave. And so after he leaves, out comes Bullet Club Gold. Switchblade tells him to head to the back. He's going to handle this himself. And then we had a very long promo segment. And essentially, MJF compared himself to filet mignon. He said Jay White was tofu. He said that Jay had been given everything. The entrance, nickname, themes, t-shirts, big match opportunities, keys to the greatest faction of all time. But if you take it all away, he's just boring, bland, tasteless tofu. And he says, I'm going to give you some advice from a real top guy. Get out of this ring, because if you don't, he said, early in my career, I kept hearing MJF is great, but he's not as good as so-and-so. He's not as good as so-and-so. But didn't bother him until he heard he's not as good as Jay White. That got him angry. So he says, if you don't get out of this ring, someday people are going to say Jay White is good, but he's no MJF. So then Jay cut a promo, and he essentially, long story short, said that he was going to take the title from MJF, and MJF would have nothing but the fans would have him, Jay White would have the AEW title, and it was all because MJF had gone soft, and he knows it. So MJF is furious, he wants to fight, Jay White bails, and looks like MJF and Jay White... I still think this is going to be Los Angeles. I have a feeling.
I mean, it could be. Could be.
Yeah. Feels like this is a pay-per-view main event. So
well, they
see.
Need more than that for a pay-per-view main event.
Well, obviously, they will have a card.
But yeah, I mean, they got...
I'm pretty sure they can make MJF and Jay White.
They got about 7 weeks before that one, so yes. They got plenty of time. If it's Los Angeles, I don't know, you know. I mean, they may, you know, they do have a show called Title Tuesday on a Tuesday. So,
then we had Jim Ross with Darby and Christian.
This was actually quite good.
This was great. So Christian claims he's been champion for months. He just retained the title in the third way, or in the three way. And Ross says, you know, he's beaten you twice. What makes you think you're going to beat him on Sunday? And Christian said they were flukes. They were non-title. And Darby knows he's not the man I am. He says, Darby uses the tables, the chairs, the gimmicks. That's why I want best of three. I want to see what he can do in a wrestling match. And he says, I'm going to humiliate him in front of his friends, his family, and his uncle. Oh, I guess it won't be because of his uncle won't be there. Of course, because he has passed away. And Darby says, you know, everybody you mention is always dead. And so, of course, Christian brings up Buddy and then Nick. And Darby says, you just want to take advantage of Nick. I won't even bring him to ringside. And you, if you have the balls, you won't bring Luchasaurus to ringside. And so apparently they're going to have a one-on-one best of three with nobody at ringside.
Think Edge might show up?
I mean, certainly people do think that's a possibility.
I mean, his contract expires.
He did say to leave Luchasaurus at ringside.
Yeah, if I mean, you know, because Edge's contract's up on Saturday, so he could appear on Sunday.
I mean, the only thing with that is, like, the moment Edge appears in AEW, he's going to get a massive babyface reaction.
Yeah.
And this is Darby Allin in Seattle.
Yeah.
And it would just be kind of weird. But they can try.
You can do it, though. I mean, you're
try.
Right. You're right. You're right. Everyone will go crazy. But, yeah, it is weird for... It's weird, but if that's the deal... Or he could cost Christian the title.
He could.
you know, come in as a babyface to feud with Christian.
He could do that, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, if there's something that's going to get him back, I mean, it's obviously working with Christian.
Yeah.
If you know, and I don't know that he's going there or not. I just know that people in WWE, at least as of a few weeks ago, believed that he was going there. I haven't really asked anyone because it hasn't been, you know, it just hasn't been anything that has come up. But when I watched that promo, I was thinking, you know, I mean, October 1st is an interesting day. And, you know, he, you know, just with nobody at ringside, that would be the you know, where you would do it.
Orange Cassidy, Matt Jackson, Penta, Austin Gunn in a four-way. It was a very fun match. Lots of four-way spots. Boom, boom, boom. And everybody hit the finish on everybody else at the end. Got the four-way striking battle, super kick party. And in the melee, Orange flew in, hit the punch on Matt, and pinned him. So there were no stakes or anything, but it was fun.
No, just to set up the 14 match on Sunday, which would be with the winners of that getting a shot at the FTR Aussie Open winners. I don't know if that's on Title Tuesday or on the next pay-per-view also. So, but future championship match. They said it at a time or place. I guess the idea is the winners can choose the time. The winners of the four-team match on Sunday can choose the time and place of their title opportunity.
We then had Willow Nightingale and Julia Hart. Willow had a bandage on her eye after getting misted off camera last week. And so Julie tried to rip it off, and Willow got mad, slammed her all over the place, and finally Julia chop blocked her outside, sliding Lear to the back of the head. Went for her finish, but Willow got the ropes, and then Willow pounced her, tied her in the tree of woe, but missed the cannonball. Julie hit the moonsault, pinned her, and then she puts her in her finish afterwards, and Statlander runs down to make the save. So that sets up Julia and Statlander.
Well, Brody King was blocking her.
Yes.
Brody King distracted Willow. Brody King has a big freaking cast on that hand, on that right hand, too, by the way. Yeah. But which is kind of hidden by clothes, but I saw it. And then the other deal, you know, I mean, as far as it was really obvious watching this that to the crowd, that Willow Nightingale is so much of a bigger star than Julia Hart, to the point where I'm watching this going like, it's almost ridiculous that Julia Hart won, except she is getting a title shot on the pay-per-view, so she had to win. I mean, she had to, but it's, again, one of those signs that, you know, I don't know what it is with Willow. She's so over with the crowd, and, I mean, she did get a push off of beating Mercedes, but then now
she won the Owen Hart Cup.
Yeah, but what have they done?
Nothing. I mean, now, that's the point.
She won the Owen Hart Cup. She got the push, but then she lost to Athena, and then, you know, she lost here, and, you know, she's the one who should have beaten Jade in the first place. But, you know, that's water under the bridge. It never happened.
Thank you for watching. Make sure you subscribe to the channel and click that notify button, and you'll never miss a video again.